Hi guys, Assalamualaikum. Can you hear me?
Waalaikumsalam, sir. Yes.
Assalamualaikum, boleh ke?
Okay, Tess, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes,
you can hear me. I dengar you all cakap tapi tak dengar. Sorry. Allah, pakai earpiece tak pakai. Alright, boleh dengar eh? Now okay? Right. A'udzubillah minasy syaitanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today kita akan buat soalan like the other groups. Kita ada buat soalan eh. This is the question. Okay, taken from one of the past year's question eh. Then why this question? Because as you can see, Granom ni, the Granom Kelson especially, pure theory of law is a favorite in the finals. So might as well for us to prepare whether we are okay to answer this or not. Okay, we have 18 here at this moment. All right. Okay, you read the question. Tengok, you boleh jawab tak? Remember, our exercise, we are not to be correct. But if you can, as much as possible, we are to try out, irrespective whether we get the wrong answer or not. Actually, there is no wrong answer or right answer, but whether we are on the right track. Should I send the thing to your website? Okay, sending to your WhatsApp. This is actually what happened in Pakistan eh? When they received their independence. The first prime minister was the first president or prime minister was ousted eh? By coup. So over that period of time, in the case of in the case of apa ya, ada lupa lah. Mana ni? Duma pula. What was the case that I gave you? Wait, ni, I know. Apa nama case ni? Ah, Dosso, aduh. In the case of Dosso, what happened was, what happened was the court, they are pro Kelsian in 1958, but 72 now they change their view, so they are more trying to reject the Kelsian model, because Kelsian model at that point of time 1958 in the case of Dosso, the Supreme Court validate the coup by the army over the country. Why they validate? Because they apply Kelsen, and since there is a vacuum, and on top of that, there is no restriction, there is no rebellion, or there is no or resistance in terms of the new government that is taking over. So that coup is considered as valid. So starting from that point onwards, the the history of Pakistan is quite is being full of apa revolution ya or coup. That is that actually a number of revolution that took place or coup that took place. Why? Because once you allow, you recognize the takeover of a government without a resistance of the society, meaning it is a good law. A good takeover. Then others can do the same thing. Okay, so they are trying themselves to remove. Now they are against Kelsen. So the question part two is asking you to use decided cases in order for you to comment the application of Kelsen pure theory of law in the situation of revolution, especially. Then the other one, part one, is talking about what is the Islamic context in terms of what was said here. Okay, what was said here. Wah, jadi macam-macam lah. Jadi macam muka orang. Alright. Guys, macam mana? Boleh jawab tak? Looking at this question. Can we have volunteers? Otherwise, I panggil orang lah. Ataupun you tengah duk. I dah bagi dah the background of the situation. So this one, they are rejecting the Kelsen model. But it was initially pro-Kelsen punya ni lah. In the case of Dosso. So I've given you the list kan? Okay. So this case is Jalani and Government of Punjab. Okay, mana dia soalan? Okay, Jalani and Government of Punjab. But the previous case would be Dosso. Yeah, ada juga dua case lagi. Yeah, but that one is also relevant. The constitutional punya argument lah. But the one that is related to apa orang panggil Kelsen would be Dosso. Right. Can we have volunteers? Otherwise, I point panggil nama. Tak ada? Ikmal? 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 Okay, macam mana kita nak push number 2? Kita nak tengok number 2. Boleh. I mute because tak nanti ni. Nur Kashifah, do you want to say something? Kamar. Dia nak masuk. Yeah, come on. Can I not try? First. Second. Third. Pause. Apa? First kita cakap apa? Ini in running number lah. Allah.
So,
yeah.
Since we have to discuss in the context of Islamic ideas, do we have to discuss, does this mean that we have to discuss in the opinion of the Islamic jurists like the four mazhab tu?
No. You don't have to go to that extent. They are the our Islamic jurists lah, kononnya ya. They are considered as Islamic jurists. But the understanding of this Islamic jurists, kita ambil general saja.
Oh, the Quran and the Sunnah.
No, kita Quran and Sunnah is a core, but if you want to go along the line of you know, this Pakistan, right, being governed by a concept of Quran, right? So in other words, we are looking at Islamic jurist. Okay, if you are looking at Islamic jurist in Pakistan, obviously they must be using some foundation of Islamic. Apa yang kita panggil dia? Apa question tu? In order for you to control a country, Ya, I cakap Sunni dia lain, Syiah dia lain. Apa yang dia punya mode of control, a governance of a country?
Is it mazhab, sir?
Yeah, mazhab. Tapi on what basis yang dia kata? Kalau Sunni dia ambil siapa?
Oh, kalau Sunni ikut Prophet Muhammad SAW, kalau Syiah ikut
Sunni, Sunni ikut sunnah lah. Sunni ikut Sunni itu sunnah. Sunnah awal jemaah tu maksudnya dia pegang kepada sunnah Rasulullah. Tapi untuk Syiah, dia pegang kepada keluarga Rasulullah. So keturunan Rasulullah sahaja yang boleh mengerti apa yang dimaksudkan dalam Quran. So jadi they are supposed to be the guardianship of Islam after Rasulullah. Okay, so that is where Syiah comes in, because they believe that the Prophet have left the apa orang kata pemerintahan. Sepatutnya kalaulah dia pilih orang nak pergi ke perang sebagai pemimpin perang, obviously dia akan tinggal somebody to pimpin Islam selepas dia mati. So there was an incident which is lepas the final sermon, which is also included the appointment of Ali as the caretaker of Islam sebagai apa, khalifah. So there is a conflict then when Abu Bakar took over and Ali is supposed to continue. So from the Shia perspective, they believe no one is to be able to identify what is the real meaning of Islam only and until the keluarga Rasulullah. So it started with Ali and then cucu dia apa, Hassan and then Hussein and then continue. So that is Shia. So kalau Islamic idea ni ditanya on sovereignty from Shia is based on apa orang kata, based on keturunan Rasulullah lah. Tapi kalau based on the Sunni or Sunnah wa Jamaah, they based on the one that have authority of knowledge, meaning the jurist, yeah, the jurist, Islamic jurist. So for example, the four mazhab lah, we have more than four. So this four actually, kalau you nak tengok apa yang mengikat dia orang ni in order for them to come up with their laws, their interpretation of law. Apa perkataan yang I sebut dalam lecture tu? Siapa yang control Islamic law? Kalau kita tengok sekarang, Islamic law controlled by whom? By the state ke by the federal?
State.
Okay, siapa yang dalam state yang control Islamic principle? Majlis Agama Islam kan? Why the majlis there? The word majlis. Saya kata Majlis Agama Islam. Agama Islam lantak lah, itu that is the name kan, ada majlis. Majlis is syura. Okay.
Is it a
expertise
on the Islamic law?
Yes, they are the Islamic jurist lah, based on the sunnah, based on hadith. So do these people, for example, like kita ambil Imam Syafi'i. Imam Syafi'i is a Islamic jurist. So why he is considered as Islamic jurist? He have knowledge in Islamic laws in terms of Quran and Hadith, right? And then on top of that, he interpret interpretation dalam Islamic law. We call it istihad. Yeah, but normally kalau orang ulama ni kalau dia buat istihad, dia tak boleh buat istihad seorang-seorang. Selalunya dia buat in consensus. Yeah, consensus kita panggil ijma', ijma' ulama. So kalau ijma' ulama is a consensus of all ulama within that particular apa understanding lah. Kalau kat Malaysia, ijma' ulama of member of majlis fatwa negara atau majlis fatwa negeri. Okay, majlis fatwa negeri terdiri daripada beberapa Islamic jurist. Jadi they understand the Islamic jurist lah by virtue of the hadith. So they are going to interpret the Islamic law. But dia ijma' and dia istihad. Istihad, I mean dia interpretation and the consensus that they receive or they make, but cannot ever override hadith and Al-Quran. Hadith tak boleh override Quran. So the highest Al-Quran, second is hadith, and then we have ijma' ulama. Boleh? That is how you answer the Islamic idea of sovereignty. The concept of sovereignty cannot, if you don't have any knowledge about sovereignty in terms of Islamic, you can always go generally and say that in order to govern a country, the governance of the country from the perspective of ulama in terms of sunnah wa jamaah, they must be the one that is doing the ijtihad or what they call it, consensus towards the Al-Quran, yeah, which is the words of Allah. So if, say for example, a country, the people who govern the country is going against the Al-Quran, therefore they have no legitimacy in ruling the country. This is where the interpretation, kalau kita tengok dekat apa, dekat overseas, dia orang takut sangat dengan dengan Islamic law. But the position is the people who are in control, kalau you dengan orang kafir, orang yang bukan Islam, so you cannot go against them because you are in that country, that unless and until they go and threat you, you have to run away. But you do not go against the person that is in control. Boleh? Lebih kurang dapat tak apa yang I try nak cakap ni? Then kalau you nak tahu in detail, you look at the Islamic idea of sovereignty in order to get in depth punya apa orang kata perspektif. Yes. Pandai tanya soalan, lepas tu saya cakap dan tak payah nak kena jawab, ya. Yeah. Nora Uni. Ha. Ana Islamic itu boleh tak? Apa soalan you on Islamic? Nora? Mana Nora? Dah hilang.
Sampai kita buka.
Ah, Nora. Yes. Macam mana yang Islamik tu boleh ke tak? Islamik
yes,
tu okey tak? Were you listening just now? On the Islamic part? I nak show you recap je. Were you listening just now? Ha Nora, macam mana? Setengah jam lah ni, kita tak buat lagi Kelson. Kamal? Nora, apa? Tak respon. Kamal, how about you? Hai. So macam mana?
Hi,
boleh? The Islamic context. Yeah.
In that sense, with the application for the Pakistan judicial TQ is where they acknowledge the part where their grant norm is based on Almighty Allah alone, and the authority is accessible by the people within the limit of what is considered as correct upon what is on the basis of Islamic, which is on Hadith and Quran, yeah. Right?
But can you agree or disagree? Up to you.
So I kind of want to raise a doubt where this application would can be considered as invalid.
yeah, because dia cuma bagi opinion. This is just opinion. It's not the apa orang kata the ratio for that decision. You know, it's just a mere statement, kan? I boleh kata. Sama kan bila you tengok apa the problem the case Doso ni, kalau you tengok Doso ni, dia started with the problem of mana dia, kita tengok Doso case. Okay, so Doso case is about this particular law tau, Frontier Crime Regulation, yang Doso kena apa was convicted. So dia macam ISA lah kan. So people argue, macam Teh Cempo argue about the legality of ISA, SCA, sorry, ISA pula. So kalau you tengok Frontier Crimes Regulation ni, dia adalah satu undang-undang yang di mana kata you tak boleh appeal, you tak ada wakil, you tak ada dalil. Maksudnya you don't have any representation, you don't have the right to be putting the evidence. There is no kind of appeal kalau dah decision that is being made by this so-called tribal punya apa kata, mana group dia, this jamu, sorry, mana jamu, the assembly that is being given their rights in order to settle problems within the tribal areas ni. Dia tribal areas dalam Pakistan ni, dia ada kawasan yang Pashtun yang kita dengar yang kena attack kan. Kalau kita tengok sini, dia ada Pakistan besar, but this one is considered as area that is self-governance. So self-governance ni dia orang ada law. Law pula, dia kalau frontier regulation ni, the laws that actually coming from British India. Because British India, they want to control the apa orang kata the area in terms of Pakistan. Orang Pashtun ni dia memang gangster lah. Dia memang tak suka diperintah. So British have an a big problem with these guys. So what happened was they create this so called kalau you tengok dia punya in terms of collective punishment. Kalau lah kata tengok, is a form of retaliation in terms of kalau perpetrator tu member, friends, acquaintance, semua kena tangkap. You know, you kira memang macam-macam lah jadi dekat dia orang. If you are arrested, there is no right for you to appeal. Dalam, you know, it's a draconian punya law created by the British in order for them to regulate ataupun control the country. So this one, the law is apa continuing. In its application. So this case was tried under that particular law, which is actually controlled by a group of this what we call lawyer Jirga, yeah, where they are the legal assembly in that particular area of Pakistan that they have self rule. So this member family member of Doso appeal lah to the High Court. So High Court kata, yeah, betul, it is against the Supreme Constitution of Pakistan. So dia menang, but appeal, the government appeal, baru nak appeal, tiba-tiba dah ada take over, yeah. So you baca sendirilah, ya. Kalau ada once the takeover the takeover happened, the government, the president was kicked off by the military. So the military remove the constitution. Once they remove the constitution, remember kita Kelsen kata apa? Kelsen kata apa? Dalam piramid atas tu kita ada legal norm dengan apa norm? Basic norm kan? Once the basic norm is removed, then therefore there is apa the structure is without apa kata main apa the foundation. Sorry, the foundation, the pinnacle of the legal system. So if there is no pinnacle of the legal system where there is no constitution, this so-called apa kata coup that took place, whether it is valid or not, it depends on whether the society have buat resistance lah. Is there any kind of you know, resistant towards the new government that is coming in? If there is no resistance, it was considered as smooth, and then no violence and things like that. Then, according to Kelsen, that apa orang kata legal norm, grand norm dah berubah. You know, kalau tidak, kalau grand norm tu tak berubah, mesti orang akan retaliate. Orang akan, you know, resistance mesti ada. But in this situation, there was no resistance. So because of the there is no resistance, the new government is considered as valid. Once the new government considered as valid, new government pula remove the old constitution. So the old constitution is no longer there. However, all other laws are still in continuation. So jadi semua structure masih ada, tapi kepala dah berubah. Court kata yes, it is because the link is from the, what do you call it, the lower or the legal norms yang ada towards the towards the main norm, which is intact, then is considered as valid. So that is why you have this question of Allah ada one also. Therefore, you have this attack towards Kelsen model that is being applied dalam DOSO. Yeah. So DOSO ni yang apply this what do you call it, Kelsen punya theory. Okay, dah ada lah doctrine of necessity that which you can, when there is a vacuum, there is a need for you to settle and put a law. Yeah, because dalam keadaan tu kita tak tahu siapa government yang valid kan. So adalah Pakistan ni penuh dengan masalah. Right. Okay, boleh nampak the background of the, what do you call it, question. So how do you approach in order for you to answer? No, Zaris?
Yes, sir.
Macam mana you nak approach? Number one apa?
So I don't really understand.
Macam mana? Macam you pening ya tengok soalan. Cuba ya, kalau tengok by referring to decided cases, okay fine, you have to find out the decided cases. Critically comment, this is what you are supposed to do, critically comment. The application of Kelsen dalam revolution punya situation, right? So you first have to set up your foundation. So you, the first thing you have to talk about, Kelsen. Sorry ya, tak guna pen, jadi guna mouse. So Kelsen, and then pure theory of law. Okay, pure theory of law. And the third one, you talk about the pure theory of law tu apa? Kita ada apa pure theory of law? Can anyone give some input? Kita ada legal wrong, kita ada moral wrong, and then legal wrong tu macam mana kita nak handle? Apa yang konsep yang Kelsen cakap? These are the one that we have to talk about. number three itu is the detail about the theory itself, how it works. Macam mana? Can we have Nazrari? Try number tiga tu.
The pure theory of law.
Apa?
On the basis that the law is excluded from any input from any other things such as moral or religious.
Custom, religion, apa semua tu kan? Okay, good. Itu dia punya opinion. Lepas tu dia keluarkan nak cari law yang sebenar, which is if you apply pure theory of law, then you can use this theory everywhere in the world, then you can find what is the law, whether the law is valid or not. Macam mana dia nak dia suggest nak pakai teori tu? Apa dalam teori tu? Betul lah apa yang you cakap tadi, betul lah. Sambungan dia?
Sambungan dia? Kejap, saya kena fikir.
So, anyone else? Syahira? Syahira Alia? Macam mana? Dia ada legal wrong dengan moral wrong kan? Moral wrong kita tak ada apa-apa lah, kita jangan menyebuk lah. Legal wrong tu kita nak handle macam mana? Kalau orang mencuri macam mana? Apa tak ada?
Pyramid tu ke sir?
Yang pyramid tu? Yang pyramid? Pyramid yang bawah apa dia?
Bawah legal norm.
Legal norm. Betul tak? Kalau ada apa, kalau legal wrong, kita ada legal norm kan? That is the norm. Apa macam mana kita kalau orang mencuri? Apa norm kita?
Letak authority untuk tangkap orang curi.
Oh, tangkap kan? Di mana orang dapat authority tu untuk nak tangkap? Kalau orang mencuri dekat shopping center, ya, dekat supermarket, boleh tak guard yang ada kat situ tangkap?
Boleh.
Tak boleh.
Tapi guard tu tangkap dulu, lepas tu baru polis datang.
Tak, dia kena assist, dia kena panggil polis untuk datang. Yang boleh tangkap ialah polis. They are not authorized. You kalau nak tangkap orang membunuh boleh. In the process of committing a crime punishable by a certain degree, yeah. They are there is a word I dah lupa lah. So punishable or heavy crime you boleh buat citizen arrest. Tetapi kalau seizable and non seizable, nanti you dah belajar criminal law, dah belajar kan?
Sir, is it referring to the first schedule under the criminal procedure, under the penal code?
So penal code tu adalah authority that is given by law to the person or to the institution to do their legal norm. Macam mana nak tangkap orang? Nak gari ke tak gari? Ingat tak perempuan yang kalau kena saman dia digari. So dia protest, dia lawan in court, salah. Prosedur salah, mana boleh civil you gari? Tak bayar saman, walaupun saman tu polis pergi gari. Ada kalau you go online, you cari kan. At one time tu polis keluar cari, ketuk rumah orang, tangkap, ambil gari orang bawa pergi balai. Tak boleh. It's a civil, bukan criminal. So authority of how they are to behave in terms of how do you normalize when it comes to theft. So you kena ada procedure tu. Siapa yang buat, mana authority itu datang? So it comes from the law. Siapa yang buat law tu, then you start to do your investigation. After you do the investigation again and again, up, going up and up and up and up, you akan sampai ke federal constitution. in countries that is ada federal constitution, okay lah. Kalau dekat Britain, kita akan tengok dia punya legislator lah, parlimen lah, because dia tak ada constitution Britain. So kalau US, dia ada dia punya constitution. Tapi kalau Arab Saudi, for example, kita tengok Brunei, so dia orang tak ada constitution. Ada constitution but the king is higher than anything else. So what I'm trying to say here is everyone, bila dia ada aktiviti yang dia perlu lakukan untuk satu jenayah, dia dapat satu power from the law. Kita punya investigation, kita kena cari mana law tu datang. Macam mana dia dapat power tu? Sah ke tak sah? Kalau kita check undang-undang tu sah, dan kita kena cari mana pula kesahihan undang-undang yang tadi yang kita buat, mana pula dia datang, dia wujud daripada law mana. So delegated legislation, you akan trace balik ke atas. Okay, daripada officer yang tangkap, daripada instruction that is given by the boss, pengarah, timbalan pengarah, and then pengarah, and then kita ketua pengarah, and then kita ada minister. Daripada minister tu kita akan nampak akta. So akta ni kita boleh cari backtrack balik, akta ni wujud datang daripada mana? Datang daripada parlimen. Parlimen pula kuasanya dia dapat daripada mana? Oh, parlimen kita dapat, dia orang dapat kuasa daripada federal constitution. Jadi itu federal constitution is considered as apa? Basic norm. Grand norm. Federal constitution is grand norm. Kenapa? Daripada grand norm tu lah terhasilnya tindakan seseorang yang polis kat bawah ni, yang dekat dalam society kita berhak untuk nak saman orang ataupun nak tangkap orang. So jadi semua proses, katalah you ambil proses with regards to mencuri, semua orang yang involved dalam proses punishment of a person yang mencuri, mereka semua dapat kuasa daripada federal constitution. Kalau you buat tracing, you akan nampak. Okay, so that is the explanation yang you kena buat dalam tiga. Tetapi yang keempat ni, dia nak kena relate kepada problem yang dekat dekat Pakistan. Okay, di mana you kena apply. So ini semua orang boleh explain. Okay, you just memorize, you just cut and paste, you know, more or less, yeah. So you boleh bagi 3.1, kata bagi example lah. So you bagi example pun boleh dalam ni, legal example. But the one that is in the question, dia nak minta you to comment with respect to the statement that is being made, which is kita ada pro Kelson dengan dan against Kelson. Di sini kita punya critical analysis. So, kalau you dah okay di sini, so di sini you akan ambil case of Dasso, okay, case of Dasso dengan case of Jalani to check the differences of court punya opinion. Guys, nampak tak? Tak nampak?
So yeah. Yang the text tu is dia tak setuju dengan Kelson lah kan? So in our analysis tu, kita macam argue balik with that statement by the judge ke?
Kita argue balik by using Kelson. So Kelson kata, memanglah kata when there is no one in control of the country, there must be some system, right? Otherwise, the country will collapse. But if you recognize someone to be a legitimate control of the country, you kena tengok the legal, the basic norm yang dia sendiri keluarkan. Kalaulah the basic norm yang dia keluarkan, maka you kena accept lah, because you dah recognize dia. Macam mana kalau you recognize orang tapi you tak recognize apa law yang dia keluarkan? So in this case of Dasso, they all recognize the coup. Okay, the court recognize the coup. Why? Because Kelson kata there must be some kind of people who are introducing the basic norm. The previous basic norm is supposed to be intact kalau apa, kalau there is a resistance of the coup. Okay, kalau orang ada coup, you lawan, everyone keluar. So, for example lah, ambil senang ya. I dah bagi example sebenarnya. Kalau lapas, they took over the government and now they come up with a law that every woman kena pakai apa, pakai pazoro tu kan? Apa orang panggil tu? Apa? Apa tudung yang bagi nampak, bagi nampak mata tu apa dia?
Niqab, sir.
Okay. So, katalah dipaksa semua Indian ini, Indian Chinese tak apa-apa. Kalau Indian Chinese tak tak cakap apa-apa, then the valid, the government is valid lah. The coup is valid. Why? Because there is no resistance. Because Kelsen kata, basic norm or grand norm can be changed. And how do you know whether the grand norm is acceptable by the society when new government comes in, there is no resistance. So jadi, logically, kalau kita tengok Kelsen, then the government, the new government is valid. So whatever the government says or come up with new law, that law is becoming the grand norm. In this case, in the case of Dasso, they rejected the previous constitution of Pakistan and they come up with martial law. So that martial law becomes the grand norm. Boleh guys? Lagi 15 minit je.
Yes. Maksudnya yang ni, although it's already overruled but it's still necessary our discussion kan?
So you boleh discuss lah Dasso dengan Jalani. So compare and contrast. Why benda ni duk berpanjangan kalau sepatutnya, or kalau Supreme Court, the later Supreme Court, kalau doctrine of binding judicial precedent kan, the later Supreme Court punya rule override the previous one, right? Betul tak? Guys? Betul? Okay, tapi initially it allows coup to happen in Pakistan. So Pakistan, rampasan kuasa ni biasalah pada dia orang. Sebab apa? It started with the acceptance of Carlson punya theory into the law, into the decision of the courts. Okay, clear?
So in our discussion, how do we provide the evidence for the resistance?
Buat statement lah apa yang apa Kiasen kata, whenever the new government is taking over the country, if there is any apa resistance, you tengok the case of Jalani dengan Dasso, dia akan talk, kita tengok sini lah. Okay. Mana dia? This is origin. Ada, kalau you tengok the case itself, you have to look at the case. So if you look at the case, ni dia bagi some kind of ada. But the decision of the Supreme Court is talking about the accepting of the new government. Ini dah. Something along that line, eh? So kalau you baca that particular case, then you will discover that their decision is based on Kelsen, whereby the hook was considered as valid. Why? Because it was there is no resistance about the new government when they come in. So the new government is to represent the society, and they represented the society by coming out with new law, which is the Grand Norm lah, new Grand Norm, the basic law. So the basic law here, we are talking about the martial law, the martial law of Pakistan. So in fact, sekarang sampai sekarang pun, they are governed under martial law. Okay, boleh? Diam dia semua. Show of hands, faham ke tak faham? Semua orang akan kata faham kan. Alright, ada tak soalan? Baik, tanya soalan lah. So, macam mana you nak link up to the problem, right? So, you boleh kata Kelsen is favored dalam kes Lasso because of the argument that was put up by the courts, the Supreme Court then, and then it was no longer accepted as a basis for the government. Tapi but until now, the Pakistan is still be under the concept of coup is something that is accepted because the law has already recognized. Okay, kalau coup tu, make sure ada resistance. Kalau tak ada coup, tak ada resistance. Kalau orang pakai consent, then the new government is valid. Boleh guys, ada soalan? Kalau tak ada, I think we end the session lah. Ada tak soalan nak tanya? Last one, anyone? Tak ada? Okay, right. So I think we end the session. Thank you so much for coming guys. See you next week lah, insyaAllah. Kita discuss lagi tentang Kelsen ni, or do another question, then you should be able to link up. Boleh guys?
Boleh sir.
Alright, so alright. Thank you very much for coming, and see you insyaAllah. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.